All right, so we learned how to change our display preferences so we can see things a little better. Another thing that we can manipulate in our interface, and in our timeline actually, is how we see these clips represented on the timeline itself. It defaults to showing you a tiny little thumbnail right here of what video clip you have on your timeline. You can actually change that. Why would you want to change it? When you're only dealing with one, maybe two lines of video, then there's no need to change it. You can just leave it the way it is in its default setting of showing you the tiny little thumbnail right there. But if you have 3, 4, 5 different video lines, as you can see, you have video 1, video 2, video 3. When you start getting into having more and more layers on your timeline, then you're going to want to see more layers at one time. So you might need to shrink this down so that way you can see. The way to change it is right over here. It says video 1. What you're going to do is you're going to go to your left. Right there, it says set display style. You're going to click on that. And then you're going to click show name only. And then it shrinks it down so you can only see. It took out the little thumbnail. Oh, I thought it would shrink it, but apparently not. If you wanted to, so it took out the thumbnail that showed you exactly what video you had there. If you want to put it back, you show frames. So that way you see the frames of each video clip all the way through. Or you can click it again, show head and tail. That means it shows it at the head, which is right at the beginning of the clip, tail at the end of the clip, and you can do to show head only. And then it'll only show you the clip, the little thumbnail, the tiny little thumbnail of the video at the head of the video. So you want to leave it defaulted at show head only. You don't want to confuse your life too much by showing frames because we're not getting into that nitty-gritty framework yet. When we start getting into cutting off tiny little frames of something, that's when you'll start to get into, okay, I want to see every single little thumbnail of the frame in this clip. For now, though, you want to keep it show head only. And if you need to change it, you can show name only. But keep the little thing on there. It just makes you feel good. If you wanted to collapse this, as you can see right here where it says video, there is a tiny little arrow that's pointed down. See how it says collapse, expand track? I'm going to click that. And when it's pointed to the right, it collapsed the track. So now, like I was saying before, you can see more video tracks at once. I can expand my audio track right here. Boom. And now I can see what kind of audio I'm looking at. My audio line, and I can better manipulate the audio and see what's going on with that. As you can see right over here, it starts to show you little frequencies to show you exactly what it is you're hearing. You can collapse that too, expand that as well, and then you see your entire video clip. So that's a really useful tool for you, but you just wanna know you have your video line, your audio line, and you can change the display preferences of those lines.